for an armbar, and I was very cognizant the whole time.
Was it the elbow that was hurt in your last fight?
It was the same one. It did flash through my mind. There was a moment I was like, oh man, you gotta be kidding me. But at that point, to be honest, like with 5-10 seconds left, even if it was on, I would have let him break it and I'd just go win the judge's decision. It doesn't matter, there was no tapping at that point.
The elbow was good throughout camp and in this fight?
Yeah, it was great. I was hoping to get some microphone time after the fight, because I wanted to thank the UFC Performance Institute. You know, the physio team in particular have done such an incredible job with me, Heather, Ryan, Tara, Bobby. Every day since October, they were on me, fixing me, making sure I recover. And I had a great healthy camp today in the warm-up, everything. I didn't feel anything, so thank you to the UFCPI, and they did an incredible job with me.
Final one for me, when do you want to get back in there now that you have your first win?
So for me, it's going to be Ramadan in the end of March. That will last a month till the end of April, and I'm going to go to London spend time with my family during Ramadan, and then I'll be back to Vegas and straight into camp. I think I want to fight maybe end of June, early July. I think that's realistic, around International Fight Week. That'll give me a good amount of time to, you know, get my weight back down and get into training, you know, because Ramadan does offset your rhythm a little bit. So yeah, it's early March now. I'm thinking end of June, early July would be good. I'm very happy with my performance. It wasn't an easy opponent, and I had it all, every round to myself, you know. I think they probably, it was 29-28, right? So every judge gave 29-28. They probably gave round two, I'm thinking, but that's when he kind of almost took my back, had that arm triangle situation. But I got out straight away, and then I took him down, landed a bunch of elbows myself, so I felt like I canceled that out and I won that round two. So yeah, for myself, it was a pretty much straightforward fight, and I'm very happy with my performance.
He would have some moments in there where it looked like he was starting to pick up the pace a bit, and I think it was the third round he shot in for a takedown, and even the commentary was like, why is he, they were shocked that he would shoot on you. Were you surprised that he shot on you in those moments?
Not really that surprised, because I knew coming in he wasn't going to stand with me, and I know these guys, they're underestimating my grappling and my wrestling, same way they underestimated Javid's grappling and wrestling. But when they get in there with us, I train with Jake Shields every day. I mean, I've got to be decent, right, by now. And I think he was probably hoping to press me, get me down to the ground, but it's not that easy, you know. I probably found the grappling easier than the striking today, you know, and he's supposed to be the wrestler, the grappler, and I'm the striker. So yeah, I'm not that surprised.
The triangle at the end, how tight was it?
Nah, it wasn't very tight at all. I heard my corner say 15 seconds left. So I'm unloaded for a bunch of punches. He did whip it up very well, but I had my chin tucked. My arm was, you know, right by my head. Elbow was upward, so he couldn't go back.
I'm Ellie Sekback. Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.